MindReader had more solves than any other challenge and was considered easy. And still, I failed to solve it. In the end, I had solved 2 medium and 1 hard challenge, so what was my issue with MindReader? Well, let me tell you about how I approached this challenge and what went wrong. MindReader. Can you read my mind? I was wondering what that could mean, reading your mind. I thought maybe it could be related to reading a process's memory. Well, challenge is running at mindreader.webctfcompetition.com, and when we visit the site, we find a very easy form with a text input. If you write something, it passes a get variable f with your input, but returns a not found error. Well, that already smells bad. So a natural first thing to do is to try local file inclusion. And sure, etc passwd works. So what do we do now? Where can we find the flag? Usually, when I work with a web challenge, I use a web proxy like Burp. My Firefox has already the proxy server configured, so I just have to start Burp and then can visit the site. Disable the request interception, visit the page, and look for the request in the HTTP history. And there it is. When you highlight it, you see the request and response details of the HTTP request down here. Then I hand over this request to the repeater, which is a neat feature of Burp where you can repeat those requests. So it becomes really easy to change the fget parameter and see the result on the right. So now I wonder what I could be looking for. I remember a few interesting files on Linux, but obviously I don't know everything. And one of the first things I noticed was the server nginx in the response, which made me start to Google for the default config and log locations because I was hoping to learn something about the web app running there. So for example, var log nginx error log or etc nginx nginx.conf, but nothing worked. At some point I opened up a terminal and connected to a Linux VM I had running somewhere to find interesting files. Especially because I want to check the proc file system. There's a lot of information about your own process there, so I try to access a few things like proc self environ, which should print the environment variables of your current process, but it didn't work. Here's the first mistake I made. I wonder if you notice it. I will come back to it in a second. I then went on and looked for other interesting files. Maybe there's something in /dev? I started continuing trying out different interesting dev files, and there was this fd folder, file descriptors, and it's actually a symlink to proc self fd, so it's pointing at your own file descriptors. You can see that fd0 returns OK, and fd1 and fd2 just keep hanging, but no error. And there seem to be even more open file descriptors, not only the standard stdin, stdout, and stderror. That's interesting, but it didn't give me anything. Anyway, this was my second mistake. Do you notice my mistake here? I didn't, so I thought this is going nowhere. So I started to work on another challenge and procrastinated checking Twitter. And then there was an unread message. This guy had some problem with Joe and asked me about it. Had a short chat about the CTF, and because he saw I didn't solve MindReader yet, he told me I could easily do it. Well, yeah, I assume because it's an easy challenge that I should be able to do it, but so far I'm stuck. And then the worst thing happened. He sent me a spoiler for the challenge. Please don't do this. If I don't solve a challenge, I don't mind, and I will seek out write-ups after the event. But in the moment, you deprive me of a valuable learning experience, because even when I'm stuck with the challenge, I start researching, and the bits of information I read and pick up left and right makes me more knowledgeable in general. And next CTF, I will be better. I tried to stay away from MindReader after that. But it was bugging me, and for my own curiosity and because I was failing with another challenge, I just had a look at what the hint is. I just can't ignore this, it's in my head. And the code revealed that the flag is in the environment variables, which I already had a hunch for as the possible place, but now I know the goal. And it also shows me why proc didn't work. There's a filter. And it hit me in the face. I realized the 2 major mistakes I made and how I could have solved it on my own. This right here has turned into a valuable lesson for me. Okay, let's have a look at my first mistake. When I try to access something in proc and get the error, it's actually a different error than when I try to access some random other file. I did not notice that. The second mistake I made was when I checked defd, because I knew it was symlink to proc selffd from my example Linux system, and while I did wonder for a second why that works, I filed it away as some small oddity. If I had made notes of the weirdness that I see with accessing proc, and that apparently the symlink works, I could have combined the two things and figured it out myself. But I didn't. I was sloppy, I didn't take proper notes, and most importantly, I didn't pay attention to the details. Oftentimes, when it comes to hunting for bugs, it's the small oddities you must not ignore. A hacker who can focus on details will discover great vulnerabilities. So, when I saw that proc was filtered and returned another error, and that I had to access process environment variables, I immediately knew what to do and tried to use the symlink to proc self environ through defd, one directory up, environ, and get the flag. Solved. Well, not really. I got a spoiler. I'm not sure if I had solved it without. Maybe, maybe not. It was certainly not hard, but I made mistakes. And while it was a good lesson for myself, I hope it will also show you that, if you allow me this arrogance, that even I can fail easy challenges. Sometimes knowledge and experience is missing, but sometimes the issue is just not paying attention to all the information you have been given.